the key is always when you have a couple of days off, you want people hitting the ground running straight away. And I think the plan's always been for today to be quite tough, tape it down a bit tomorrow, and then slightly easier day on Thursday, ready for Friday's game. So, I mean, the one thing we practice all the way through, both Sri Lanka and here, it's almost been a case of reining the lads in as opposed to having to push them any harder. So we've got a good group that train hard and train well, and I think that the fact that so many were down at breakfast early this morning shows they were looking forward to getting back to cricket. In a sense, it's everything that you want from this tournament. I mean, we came here saying that we want to be as successful in this tournament as we possibly can, and that's the same with any tournament that you're playing. But to have a must-win game on Friday is exactly what World Cup cricket's going to be about. So I think it's a great opportunity for us. And we've talked a lot about trying to win back-to-back games, and, you know, obviously disappointed not to win in Hobart, but we've had a few days to clear our heads, talk positively about what we did well, and then look forward to Friday's game. And it's an ideal build-up. I mean, no complaints whatsoever. You have 3 days to build up to a one-day game, having had 3 days of non-cricket. I mean, that's almost the perfect build-up for us, really. So, you know, everyone is looking forward to Friday, and it is a must-win game, and that's what you're going to have at this level as often as possible. That is the key, that you want to win every game that you play. We're a developing team. We are improving with every game that we play, but we want to win games, and it's about winning games at cricket. And you're not, you know, you don't ever get remembered for being a team that developed well over a long period of time. You get remembered for being a team that wins games of cricket, and we're going to cricket. And Friday is a huge game of cricket for us. Everybody knows that, and everybody in the squad is desperate to play and put on a performance, and that's what they should be doing. Effectively, it's semi-final, isn't it? And that's what, you know, we're hoping that we will be involved in knockout games in the latter part of the World Cup. So, you know, it's a huge opportunity for us to play two of the best teams in the world in the space of 3 days. We've made big improvements. We felt that we made big improvements from the Sydney game to the Hobart game. And obviously we want to play against Australia again on Sunday here in Perth, because, you know, it's another part of the learning for, you know, a team that every game we play is a massive advantage for us. Every game and every over that Stuart plays is getting better and better. And he's a high quality player for us. He's one of the best players in world cricket. It's the first time we've had him in the three or four series that I've been involved with England in one day cricket. And he's a massive asset to us because, you know, he's the sort of player that takes the game by the scruff of the neck. And, you know, he is a world class performer. And, you know, not every team has that many in their side. And he's someone who just needs to get himself back to 100%. And he's not far off that, to be fair. Belly has grown in confidence right the way through the tournament. You know, I think he's someone that, you know, obviously was frustrated by not playing in the games he wanted to play in Sri Lanka. And he's taken his opportunity right from the two practice games. He's taken his opportunity. So everybody knows Ian Bell, again, is a world-class, high-class player. And he's just showing that with the innings that he plays.